Hi friends, this is Kruti Jai Pancholi, Assistant Professor in LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication. This video is about subject Microwave Engineering. So now, in the last video, you learned about the microwave heating. Now, other application of the microwave heating, that is in the microwave oven. So now, what is the microwave oven? As we people are using in our day-to-day life for cooking the food. So, the microwave oven, how it cook the food and how the microwaves that can be used for the cooking the food inside the microwave oven. So, the microwave that cause the molecules in the food to vibrate, and this create the heat and which will cook the food. The heat from the food that warms the container that the food is in. Okay, so this way the microwaves that can be used. Now some areas that get the more microwaves and that results in the uneven cooking. That is why the rotating disc on which we are putting the container, okay, that is required to cook the food evenly. So now the microwaves are attracted to water, fat and sugar molecules, and due to that it causes them to vibrate and heat, and due to that the food that can be cooked. So now here you can see that inside the microwave oven, the waves which is emitted and opening in the metal case. So you can see that the how that can be, the waves are there inside the microwave oven. The other thing that will what happen, the microwaves that are reflected off the sides and penetrate foods in the process. So you can see that the how the microwaves that are reflected, how they reach to the food molecules from the container. Okay, so this is the thing, okay, that how the microwave that cooked the food. So food and the cookware that taken out of a microwave oven is rarely much hotter than the 100 degree Celsius. Now you have to be careful while you are selecting the cookware to cook the food. So cookware that is used in a microwave oven, okay, that is often much cooler than the food, because the microwaves heat the food directly and the cookware is heated by the food. Okay, so that is why the selection of the cookware again is the important. So food and the cookware from a conventional oven on the other hand are the same temperature as the rest of the oven, and the typical cooking temperature is the 180 degree Celsius or 360 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, so this means that the conventional stoves and the ovens that can cause the more serious burns. Okay, so this is about how it cook the food. What is the limitation of it? So limitations, that is microwaves cannot go through metal. Microwaves cannot go through metal, but they do pass through the glass, ceramic, plastic or the paper. So you people can use the foil, you can use the good plastic container, the specific ceramic container, the glass container to cook the food, so that the microwave that enters through that material, okay, and it cooks the food evenly. Hence the glass, ceramic or the plastic dishes that are safe in the microwave oven. Okay, now the next application of that is the instrumentation landing system. So instrumentation landing system, now whenever there is a the aircraft. Okay, so now the aircraft, when it is to be the landed, okay, so what is the system that is required for the security for the pilot, okay, so that it can take the particular decision? So that is required the ILS system. So ILS is the instrument landing system, and it is a ground-based radio beam transmitter, and that provides the direction to an aircraft approaching and landing on a runway. So without having the signals from this, the pilot is not deciding for the landing onto the runway. Okay, so approaching the aircraft that tune that receiver to the ILS frequency can get the guidance from the ILS. So here you can see that there are the various transmitters are there. Okay, the inside the aircraft, the receivers are there, and by tuning this transmitting and the receiving frequency, they will deciding about the runway. Okay, they will deciding about that whether okay it is to be landed onto the runway or not. So why do pilot need ILS? That is to enable the safe landing during the reduced visibility due to fog, rain or snow. We know that while the atmosphere is not good, okay, at that time this will gives you the perfect decision, okay, and we can come out from the accident. If an aircraft is considerably heavy for a runway length, guidance to the exact touchdown zone that is always required. Okay, so in order to enable auto land in a new aircraft, ILS signals are essential. Okay, so this way the ILS system, that is very very important. Now in the year of the 1929, okay, test of the first ILS that began. Okay, and the first scheduled passenger airliner to land using ILS was in the year of the 1938. So in that time the manual system were there, but right now everything the auto land systems, okay, that is there, okay, for the security purposes. Now the ILS, okay, in that the types of the runway approach. So normally there are the non-instrumentation runway, mean that in that particular runway that is intended for the operation of the aircraft using visual approach procedure. The second is the instrumentation runway. Now this instrumentation runway means a runway that is intended for the operation of the aircraft using instrument approach procedure. Now this instrumentation runway, it is again having the two category. One is the non-precision runway. The non-precision runway, okay, in that the instrument that runway sound by the visual aid and the non-visual aid providing at least lateral guidance adequate for the straight in approach. The precision runway, okay, that allows the operations with a decision height and visibility ILS category 1 or 2 or 3. So this way there are the three runways are there. You can see that in the first diagram, okay, that is the non-instrument runway. The second runway, that is the non-precision runway, and this is the runway, okay, that you can see, okay, it's a precision runway. Okay, so this way the ILS system that is used, okay, and this can be very very useful for the pilot. Okay, now for doing this, which are the components that are required? So the component that required for the ILS systems for the ground installation and the airborne equipments, okay, so those components are the three component: ground localizer, mean in that the antenna is used, okay, that is for providing the horizontal navigation. Okay, then the second component is required, that is the ground glide path antenna, that is for providing the vertical navigation. So horizontal navigation, vertical navigation, and the marker beacons, okay, that is for providing the aircraft height and distance to runway. Okay, so this way, this all three components, okay, that will make the ILS system fulfilled. Okay, so this way the ILS system that is used. Now the second application, that are recent trends, radar based navigational system. Okay, so now here you can see that how the radar that can be used for the navigational purpose. Okay, so you know that the control of the motion of the vehicle guidance through sea, land or air to the desired destination, that is called the navigation. It can be the marine navigation or the aerial navigation. The main component that is required for any navigational radar is its antenna system. Okay, so antenna system, that depends on what? So what is the antenna field pattern, what is the beam width, what is the efficiency of that antenna. So according to all that thing, okay, the selection of the antenna for the radar that has been done, and which gives us the as an output, okay, that is what is the relative speed, okay, what is the distance of that particular object, what is the, which is the what is the angle. So this all are the outcomes, okay, that is the results of the navigational system. Okay, the other applications of the microwaves, okay, that are in the field of the telecommunication. We know that the mobile phones we are using, okay, in that to transmit the wave, the microwaves that can be used. So all the mobile towers, okay, they are using the frequency that is in the range of the microwave. In the optical communication, also the microwaves that can be used. Domestic application, the surveillance, okay. So these all are the applications that can be by the microwaves, okay. So these way, these all are the applications, the recent trends, okay, of the microwave. So thank you very much, everyone.